Hello everybody, welcome to Mike's Mike. My name is Mike. And just to get this out of the way to start with, I just realized I look like the elf from Elf. That was not intentional, but we're gonna go with it anyway. Now the purpose of this video is for me to tell a story that I have told on my channel before, but the first time I told it, I had something like 15 or 20 subscribers or something like that. And now I have a lot more than that, which is cool. But the story, is about events that happened 2.5 years ago, I think. Three and a half years ago. Wow, that's hectic. But if you go back and watch the first video about this, I can't remember what it's called. You'll find it. It's in the title somewhere. There will be differences in the story, mainly because I have a shitty memory and I can't remember exactly what happened, but I remember the key parts, so I'm probably going to stitch them together and probably will stuff it up. But regardless, here we go. So the title, bit dramatic, but accurate. So let's take it back. Let's take it back to, I think it's June 2015, and I'm in Rome with my family, chilling, having a fun time. We are doing the touristy things. We're going around looking at stuff, and that's the first mistake on my behalf. So I had this bougie hat. Your boy went to Zara. I went to Zara, got a bougie hat, walking around with that bitch around Rome. And then I was like, I don't need to put any more sun protection on because of this. This hat does it all for me, chief. No. So I was severely dehydrated to start with. So we were walking around the Vatican, I think. But the Vatican's indoors. So you're like, boy, how did you get sunburned in the Vatican? No. On the bus to and from the Vatican, I got really badly sunburned and really badly dehydrated. Okay. So that's mistake number one. Mistake number two, we go back to the hotel / Airbnb thing I was staying at, and it was bougie as hell. My mum kind of snapped on the booking there. I don't think she was expecting to be that level of bougie, because I certainly wasn't, but I enjoyed it. I had an Xbox, and that comes into the story later. But this bougie Airbnb apartment thing had a sauna, and I had never been in a sauna before, and I was like, you know what? I'm feeling a little bit crusty. Why don't I go in the sauna? Little did I know that I was severely dehydrated and going into the sauna would make the dehydration worse. God, I was such a dumb bitch. But anyway, yeah, so I went into the sauna and I like this for God knows how long. I was just like, yep, this is great. Love this for me. Perfect. Great. So that was mistake number two. Mistake number three, I got to pick where we're going for dinner, which is honestly never a good idea. But hopefully my app will fix that. Wow. Wow, previewing. But regardless, so I was like, you know, I love motorbikes. There's a Ducati cafe around the corner. Let's go to the Ducati cafe. And I could tell my family was kind of like, looks a bit crusty, but sure, let's do it because he said so. So we go to the Ducati cafe and I get this big ass burger and it had a big ass patty in it. But that bitch was big ass raw in the middle. And I was like, no, we're in Italy. I'm going to eat as the Italians do. And I'm going to eat the meat. Dumb bitch. Moment number, what even, are we up to number three or number four? Let's say number three. If processed meat is raw, that ain't the good shit. That's bad. If it's a steak and she's a little bit pink in the middle, sure, do what you need to do. But if it's a minced meat patty and it's red in the middle, that should not be happening. Anyway, so I ate the minced meat raw burger and I'm guessing you can tell what happens next. No, there's a bit in between. So I get back to the apartment, we go to sleep, and I start feeling really, really, really full. You know when you start feeling really bloated, but you're not sure why? I know I ate a lot, but I didn't think I ate so much that I felt I was going to explode. It was so tense in my stomach. And I was I'm just going to try and go to sleep. Did not work. So after a couple of hours of trying to sleep, I got up, went to the bathroom, did a masterpiece with my mouth around the bathroom. Just a nice little quacha-cha spray around the walls. Lovely. Love that for me. Love that for my family. Love that for all involved. So I was really, 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 really sick. I remember laying in my parents' bed in the bougie Airbnb playing Xbox. It was like fucking Italian Tony Hawk or something. And my dad going to buy me Italian medicine and electrolytes because I was a crusty bitch. I looked like Nicholas Flamel from the new Harry Potter movie, that crusty looking bitch. That was me. Story doesn't end there though. So this was the day before we were supposed to go to Croatia. So we're going to Croatia to visit family. We were all really excited about it. And then me, being the sick bitch that I was like, I'm going to die. All right. So we get in the taxi. So yeah, I mean, I kind of skipped a bit of time there, but key points. I was sick in the bed, didn't move, had electrolytes, then suddenly had to go from the bed to a plane. And to do that, you have to go in a taxi. Now there's a minor segue here about when we got in the taxi and my sister sat on the seatbelt like clip-in thing and like screamed, and she had like this huge giant like boil on her like back because she sat on the seatbelt thing, which was kind of funny, but then not funny. It was really scary. Anyway, so I get in the taxi dead as shit. Then I get to Rome Airport. I can remember this because I've never felt that sick. Like, I was sitting in Rome Airport. No, I wasn't even sitting because there was no fucking seats anywhere because they were renovating the damn airport. God, what a disaster this was. Yeah, so I was sitting on my suitcase and I had my, like, bougie hat on. Maybe I looked like a snack, but I didn't feel like a snack. I was, like, sitting on the suitcase. I was like this. Like, literally looked like a piece of paper. I was that white. I mean, I'm white anyway, but you know what I mean. And so I was not thriving to start with. I could not have thrived less, I think. Have I thrived less? No, that's my lowest thrive point. Like, my thrive points were negative. Anyway, so we get on this plane, and just to add a little bit of fun, it was a discount airline. So Jetstar is like a discount airline. Tiger Air is like a discount airline in Australia. I can't remember this one. I think it was called Vueling. It was like a Spanish airline. It was like yellow. If that's the right one, let me know in the comments. But yeah, so we get on this plane and she's delayed because the luggage belts were broken. So they had to wheel out all the suitcases to the airplane. Sure, go off, I guess. So it was delayed like an hour. Then we got on the plane and then takeoff was delayed by another 2 hours for an engineering thing. Lest we forget, at this point, I'm severely dehydrated, haven't eaten in like 2 days, felt like I was going to faint. I probably did faint, honestly. I probably dropped in and out of consciousness. Lol, that's so dramatic, but like, I think it's true. Anyway, so then we finally take off in the air, and I'm like, finally, get me up to that altitude so I can get down again. It's supposed to be like a quick flight. And, you know, discount airline, no food, no water, whatever. It's cool, it's fine. I'll just listen to my music. At this point, I would like to mention the playlist that I have on Spotify called Plane Crash Playlist, or more specifically, I think it's called When My Plane Nearly Crashed in 2015. Now, this is the flight chief. So me on a plane, severely dehydrated with food poisoning, in and out of consciousness, the plane nearly crashed. So let me describe that for you. We were like doing this, then we're 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 doing this. So what that means is we were landing in, I think we're landing in Split in Croatia, and the plane's like coming in to land, and I'm like, get this bitch off the plane, I'm going to scream. So I shouldn't have thought that, because get this bitch off the plane, get me off the plane safely, I think I should have been thinking. But anyway, so we're going like down towards the tarmac, and the plane, like, I remember looking out the window thinking, maybe I'm cooked as shit right now, or we're quite close to these buildings and I ain't seen a motherfucking tarmac. You know what I'm saying? So I was like, I could see like the roofs of buildings. I was like, cool, love that they're so close to me. Love that. And it goes down, 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 down. And then all of a sudden, the plane just goes like fucking yeet and just like pulls like a, like more than 90 degrees, well, like less than 90 degrees, like an acute angle. So like, I guess it would be like, what is that? 100? Yeah, like a bougie angle, essentially. And we like went down and then we went fucking straight up, right? And there was a couple of people screaming on the plane. They're like, ah! And I was just like, honestly, at this point, I don't give a shit anymore. Like, if this is how I'm gonna go, let it happen, because I will scream otherwise, because I feel like absolute death already. So there was a guy like clutching like the sides of the seats, like going like this. There were other people like freaking out, people yelling, and I'm just like, what's tea? What's up? What's up, crew? And then, so we were supposed to land. He missed the runway. That's what he said. It came over the thing. He was like, hey guys, hey y'all. Just thought I'd say, this is all in like fucking Spanish. Just thought I'd just mention that we missed the motherfucking tarmac, so we got to go around and do that shit again. So we went around like a bit of airspace around Split again, and then re-landed this time safely. But the moral of the story is we were going down too fast compared to the runway, so we nearly landed in the fucking buildings, which means we nearly crashed. So I wasn't being dramatic when I said my plane nearly crashed in 2015. Those be the facts. Now, I mean, after I landed in Croatia, saw the fam, loved that for all involved. Duh. I was really sick, as we've established multiple times in this video. I had to get blood tests done in Croatia. I had to see multiple doctors in Croatia. I remember one saying that I had food poisoning. One was like, you have severe exhaustion, you have fatigue, blah, 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 blah. And I guess key points to take away from this story is that I've never been the same again, to quote Mel C in Left Eye, that lovely 2001 hit. I had never been able to eat as much after Europe since the food issues that happened. I always feel nauseous, some days worse than other ones. I kind of hate flying a little bit, but I don't hate it too much because I studied engineering and I understand how it works. I'm like, cool, love this for all involved. But yeah, that's the story about how I almost died. It was just a comedy of errors. I don't even know if I could call it a comedy. It's such a good story though. It's like a good one to whip out to my 630 subscribers. Love all of you. I said the word love so many times in this video, but I don't regret any of it. Don't regret any of it. Yeah, screaming that this was all in one take. What an iconic moment for everyone. I think I'm practicing for live streaming. I think that's what I'm trying to do here. I don't know. Like, how cool would it be if I could live stream every day at the same time, like a TV show? Graham Norton who? Anyway, if you've got some thoughts or if you've had like a near-death experience, I would love to hear them in the comments, but like not like a really like scary one, just like a fun one, like a plane crash, like me, you know, like a fun, light, near-death experience. And if you liked the video, leave a like. If you want to go back and watch the first one, which is probably more factually correct, I probably embellished a ton of shit, but also not really this time around. And if you're not subscribed already, hit that subscribe button. There will be, this is going out Thursday, so there'll be one more video this week at 8 a.m. Australian Eastern Daylight Time tomorrow. So I'll see you guys then, and I hope you have a good day. Talk to you soon. Peace out. Bye.